discerned and deciphered a wide variety of transcriptions, mostly referring to primitive belief systems or deeds in battle, peculiar to the type of writing. My attentions were drawn, however, to a transcription already rendered into legible text by the facilitator of the cipher, Dr. Marion Tarknassus. Clearly, it had been marked out as having a particular significance, given that I concluded quite suddenly by presenting an enigma. At first, I was confused. I stared and wrangled over what was plainly a series of digits and dots, which after a prolonged period of irate head-scratching, I soon realized formed the longitudinal and latitudinal coordinates of a geographical location. When I applied them to my maps, I quickly recognized a known site of archaeological interest, the sea stack of Dunakir, lying slightly to the north of the ancient seat of Donotu Castle. I was incredulous at such an astonishing find. How could it be possible to think that the modern geographic coordinate system had somehow been deployed in the very depths of human antiquities? It didn't make sense, none at all. With my head full of resounding amazement and my curiosity set wildly ablaze, I made my preparations, gathered some equipment, and traveled south the following day to the town of Stonehaven. From there, I made my way along the rugged coastline to a secluded beach, thenceforth to scale the precipitous heights of Dunakir, to see what I might find there.